Very good morning, students. Welcome back to IoT and Wireless Sensor Network subject. Last class we discussed about low duty cycle protocol and backup channel concept. Today we'll discuss the next communication protocol called SMAC. SMAC is nothing but Sensor Media Access Control Protocol. This protocol adopts a periodic wake-up scheme, that is, each node alternates between a fixed length listen period and a fixed length sleep period according to its schedule. So looking at the diagram, each node listen period is subdivided into three different phases. The first one is sync phase, then for RTS, then CTS. Sync phase is nothing but synchronization period. RTS is nothing but request to send period, then CTS is nothing but clear to send period. In the synchronization phase, the node accepts sync packets from its neighbor. In these packets, the neighbors describe their own schedule and extol their schedule in table. Whereas in the RTS, request to send, then node listens to RTS packet from neighboring nodes. Then account to it, it will act. Then CTS, clear to send. In the clear to send, okay, so if nothing is there on the channel, then node will start to communicate, transmitting its data packet to neighbor nodes. So these are the things which are used in this particular SMAC protocol. And again, the switch nodes off ensure that neighboring nodes turn on simultaneously to allow packet exchange. Okay, so again, only these active periods packet exchange happens. Okay, so this is how it is there. Now coming to the next important type of communication protocol, we call it as a contention based protocol. In the contention based protocol, we have to study two important protocol, CSMA protocol, PAMAS protocol. CSMA is nothing but carrier sends multiple access protocol. PAMAS is power aware multi access with signaling. So CSMA, so in the CSMA protocol, okay, so carrier sends multiple access. Listen before transmitting your data. Listening the channel, if channel is idle, then only you are going to send the data. Otherwise, you keep on checking the channel. Carrier sends in the sense, you keep on checking idle channel. If channel is busy, you have to wait for some random time of duration. After channel becomes idle, then only you are going to send. So carrier sends. Carrier is nothing but the channel. Carrier sends multiple access. Okay, so that is the main important thing of this particular protocol. So again, it has got the diagram schematic of the CSMA protocol, right? So here what we have to see, looking at the diagram, okay, so first so after node gets a new packet for transmission from its upper layer. So starting one is, so looking here, so here, okay, so see, since the channel is idle, okay, then we have to C and A. C is condition, A is action. So no condition is there, action num travel, trials are zero because it is transmitting first time, no repeated, no transmission, it is the first time transmission. So that's why num trials are zero. So if the node has got some packets from the upper layers, then it has to wait, then listen. So listening the channel. So if the channel is going to be idle, then it will go to the next. Otherwise, if the channel is busy, see, C is timeout, then action is nothing. See, this is very, very important. So if the channel is busy and num trials is less than the maximum trial, then it goes to the backoff. Backoff is the one mode in which the node will wait for some random amount of time. After that, it will come back again, it will sense. And again it goes. See, once this busy and num trials equal to maximum trials, because in any system you cannot try it for most number of times. They will fix some threshold, say 10 times you can check it. After 10 times, if it exceeds the 10, then you have to go to the idle. This is the things. Okay, so see, the num trials is equal to the maximum trial. Okay, so if it crosses the threshold, then it goes to the idle. Otherwise, if trials are less than the maximum, say if you are fixing the trials of 10 times, so if it is 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times, you are allowed. But when once it increases to 10, 1, then it goes back to the idle. Suppose the condition is idle, then it will send RTS, request to send. I will sending the packet. Are you ready to accept my, you know, the data? It will send this request to the neighbor node. So then awaits CTS. CTS is nothing but clear to send. Suppose assume that the neighbor node is ready to accept your data. It will send got CTS. It will send this CTS to you. Then after that it will send a data. Then it is wait for the acknowledgement. Okay, then everything is done, then indicate success, then it goes to the idle. So if anything happens, again it goes to the timeout, then it will check the number of trials is equal to the maximum trial. See, for all the actions, there is a some maximum trials are fixed. If you cross that particular trial, then it will go back to the idle state. See, so that is the important thing. CSMA, in the sense, first it will check. First, it will check if any packet is ready to send, it will check the, you know, channel. If channel is going to be idle, then it will send the RTS to the neighbor node. In response to RTS, if a neighbor node sends CTS, then it will send the data. So this is overall transmission of that. So this is the one important concept of the CSMA. So this is very, very important concept of the CSMA. Okay, if anything happens, suppose if the channel is goes on busy, then it will drop the packet and goes back to the idle. So that is the main important thing of the CSMA protocol, carrier sense multiple access protocol. So listen before transmitting, then listen, in the sense it has to check the channel state. If channel state is idle, then only you are allowed to send the data. If channel is busy, then you are stopped. So this is the first one. The second one is PAMAS, power aware multiple multi access signaling. So here, so this is, it provided detailed overriding avoidance mechanism while it does not consider the idle vessel problem. The protocol combines busy tone solution and RTS handshake similar to the MACA protocol. So it has two channel, data channel and control channel. So let's start with the one example. Okay, suppose we have three node in network A, B, C. Okay, say A wants to send data to B. Suppose A wants to send data to B. In that case, see, it will send first. A send RTS, request it has to send first RTS to B. Then assuming that C is sending busy tone, because it is receiving data from other node, okay, so it will send busy tone to neighbors. So C is also sending busy tone to A, but A is requesting to B. Then if there is nothing is there, C will send CTS. B will send CTS, clear to send, because I am ready to accept your data. Okay, so CTS and this busy tone collide. See, C is sending busy tone and B is sending CTS. Both will collide, but does not send data. Actually, there is no problem in sending the data from A to B. Because of this collision of the CTS and busy tone, then see, this is how we shown here. Busy tone by C, then RTS and CTS. So because of this collide, because these will collide in the control channel, no data will be sent. Okay, so see, you got my point. So this is very, very important things in the PAMAS, power aware multi access with signaling protocol. Now coming to the very important protocol, different classification of the protocol, we studied contention based. Now we have to study scheduled based protocols. So there are three types of scheduled based protocol. One is called Leech, SMAX, TRAMA. Leech is nothing but low energy adaptive clustering hierarchy. SMAX is nothing but self organizing media access control for sensor networks. TRAMA is traffic adaptive media access protocol. So let's see the first protocol, Leech, low energy adaptive clustering protocol. So in this one, the first thing is, first we have to form the clusters. So cluster 1 is there, cluster 2 is there. So idea, group of nodes will become the cluster. Once you form the cluster, so we have to select one node as a cluster head in each cluster. So for each cluster, we have to select a cluster head. The remaining nodes will act as a cluster node. See, so cluster head for each cluster and remaining nodes will act as a cluster node. So this is a very, very important, you know, concept of the Leech. So first, the number of nodes is grouped into the different cluster. For each cluster, it will select one cluster head and remaining nodes will act as a cluster node, and that through that cluster head only the communication will start to communicate. See, all these cluster nodes will start to send the data to the cluster head. Then from this cluster head, it will send to the base station. Again from this one, so it will send to the different. So inter-cluster communication should take place through the cluster head and base station. So this is there. Again, this cluster head, okay, so it has got the different rounds. Okay, so here in the cluster head, we have the different rounds. Okay, so that, you know, the protocol is organized in rounds. In each round, we have setup phase and study phase. The protocol is organized to round, and it has got, in each round we have setup phase and steady state phase. In the setup phase, we have advertisement of phase, cluster head, cluster setup phase and broadcast schedule. Whereas in the steady state phase, we have the different time slot to send the data. So this is very, very important. So overall, Leech protocol is, so low energy adaptive clustering hierarchy. Since clustering is there, so in the entire wireless network, the wireless network is divided into the cluster, and for each cluster we have to select the cluster head. Through cluster head only all cluster nodes are going to be communicate. So this is the very, very important concept of the Leech. So Leech has got number of things, so that's why we have to study these protocol is organized into rounds. Then the round is divided into setup phase and steady state. In the setup phase, advertising phase, so again in the advertise, it has to be select the cluster head. After that, members are going to be compete with the CSMA, so many things. So how to select the cluster head, again it's a issues. So there are so many parameter will decide the cluster head. The node has to become a cluster head. One can see the so many parameter. First one is the energy. So if the energy of the node is very high, yes, you can become the cluster head. Like that, there are so many parameter which can decide who will become the cluster head of that particular cluster. Okay, so this is the first one in the schedule based. Again, we have the self-organizing media access control for sensor network. Then again, we have so many things to study for this. Okay, so SMAX and TRAMA. Okay, so here TRAMA is there, even the links, SMAX link setup has to be studied. Then after that, TRAMA, traffic adaptive media access protocol, again we have to study in detail of this. Okay, so again, what are the different conflicts of TRAMA? Okay, so that we'll see in the next class. Okay, so today's class we studied the scheduled, contention based protocol and schedule based protocol. थैंक यू.